If you want to do this, or this, or even this, then stick around. Coming up next is the top 5 best auto moderator essentials for your Reddit page. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, we're going to go over the top 5 best auto moderator essentials for your Reddit page. Make sure to comment, like, subscribe. Let me know if you guys enjoy this video. I appreciate all the comments on the other auto moderator videos. If it weren't for all your guys' support on the other videos, I wouldn't be making this video right now. So thank you guys so much for commenting. As always, let me know what you guys think down below, and let's get into the video. How we want to start out this first one is we want to start out with exactly 3 hyphens, and then we'll go on to a new line with enter. And what we want to do to comment on all of the posts that get posted to the Reddit, we want to put in type submission. So this is going to look at every single submission to our Reddit page. So anytime somebody posts something on the Reddit page as an actual submission, not a comment, just a submission, it will trigger whatever we want it to do here. We also could go even more in depth and be like, if somebody says hi, or somebody says, or puts a link or something, then we can just target those posts and then comment on this. But we want to just target every single submission. So we're just going to put in comment here. So then we can put in whatever we want here, join our Discord. And then we can throw in a link to our Discord. So now it's going to say join our Discord. And there's the link to the Discord. We're going to go ahead and test this out. We're going to have the code on the side of the screen so you can see where the code is. But our code is in NHL 24 ESHL. Let's go ahead and create the post. Automod will comment on this post. And then let's give it a post. You see we have one comment. It doesn't show here. And if I refresh, there we go. We've got the comments from Automod. Join our Discord, and the Discord link is right in there. For this one here, we're going to reply to every single comment. What we want to do is we want to start out with 3 hyphens, then type comments, and then we can write our comments. I will reply to all comments. So also, if we want, we can also lock this comment so that way no one can reply to it. It'll automatically be locked. It's up to you guys if you want, but if you want to do that, you type in comment locked true. If not, you can leave this out, or you can make it false, or you don't have to have it. If you don't have it, it'll automatically be unlocked for people to reply to. We'll give that a save, and then let's go test it out. So let's take our post that we had before. I'm going to have the code on the side of the screen so you can see what we're doing. I already typed a comment. Hi, this is a comment. Let's comment. All right, and now let's refresh the page. Look at that. I will reply to all comments. The comment is locked. So I changed up the code. And we're going to do, this is not going to be locked. So it's going to respond, and it's not going to be locked. All right, let's refresh the page to see this next comment. All right, this is not going to be locked. We have, hi, this is a comment, it's locked. And this is not going to be locked. It's not a locked comment. I can reply, hi. Well, I am a moderator, so I should be able to reply to this one too since it's locked, hi. Yep, just because I'm a moderator, I can still reply to that one. If you want to see how to get auto moderator to also block your moderators from doing something, I'll show you guys that one next. So for this one, we're going to moderate the moderators. I have a starter script here that removes all submissions and then comments. Posts are not allowed on this subreddit. By default, moderators are allowed to post whatever they want, and they don't have to worry about getting removed from auto moderator. In this script, we're removing all of the submissions that get submitted to the subreddit, but moderators can still post because they can post whenever they want. However, if we type in moderators exempt false, now the moderators also have to follow this rule. Let's put a little extra on the comment. Let's give this one a try. All right, so we're at the NHL 24 homepage. I'm logged into my moderator account, and I got the code on the corner of the screen for you guys to reference. Let's go ahead and create this post. This post will not post. And let's give it a post. This post was removed by NHL 24 ESHL moderator, auto moderator. If we refresh the page, there's our comment, auto moderator. Posts are not allowed on this subreddit, even for mods. So let's go and change that code up without the mods exempt, and I'll try to post on my moderator account. All right, I've got the new code up there. This post will post. Let's give it a post. I'm still on my moderator account. Nothing yet. Let's refresh the page. All right, this post posted. The moderator's exempt was not on there, so moderators are not exempt. Now I'm going to show you guys without a moderator account and this same code. All right, I am logged into an account that is not a moderator. Let's go ahead and let's try to post. Let's give it a post. And sorry, this post has been removed by the moderators of NHL 24 ESHL. We refresh the page. Let's try to comment, test. For some reason, you have to try to comment, and then the auto moderator comment comes through. Why is it not coming through? But anyway, I don't know why it's not coming through, but the comment, it said there was a comment there, and also because it's not a moderator and we just had that, there you go. It shows you guys that all of those work. For this next one, we're going to direct message a user, or more specifically, we're going to direct message the submitter. If you guys don't know what that is, if you go to your notifications, you're going to see some auto moderator notifications for when something happens with your account, then they don't actually send you a message. But if you click on this messages thing here, it'll pop open your inbox. So you can actually send people's messages to their inbox when they do something. So for example, this will be for submitting. So in order to start this, we need to do exactly three hyphens. Type is going to be submission. So we want to do every single submission. We're going to do message. And then we are going to type our message. This post is suspicious. I don't know how to spell it. Right now, we can send it like that, where all of our submissions, we're going to write a message to their inbox and say this post is suspicious. However, if we don't have a message subject, it's just going to pop up in bold right when you first look at it that it is an auto moderator notification. So if we want to actually title this notification, we can type in message subject. So then in our message subject, we could write in, I'm watching you. There. Let's give this one a test. All right, we're back on the NHL 24 homepage. I'm on my moderator account because I'm not removing a post. It'll still send me a message and I don't get exempt from this by default. So let's make another post. And give it a post. All right, let's make another post. Let's give it a refresh. And now we have another notification, but that notification isn't right here. This was 17 minutes ago. It's a message. If we hit the messages, we can see in our inbox that we sent, I'm watching you, from auto moderator and says this post is suspicious, which is our let's make another post. You can see there's other things over here, but these are post replies and comment replies. This one is an actual direct inbox direct message. This one's directly from auto moderator, and you can title it. For this last one, we're going to alert the moderators with a mod mail that something is going on in the Reddit and they should check it out. So we want to start out with three hyphens, type submission. You can have it as a comment if you want. It really just depends on how you configure it. Mod mail. This post is suspicious. You should check it out. I don't know how to spell suspicious, but that's going to be our description of our mod mail. And again, if you don't have a mod mail title, just like the message title that we did on the previous one, you will just have the regular auto moderator notification as the title. So if you want a title, type in mod mail subject suspicious posts. And I do not know how to spell suspicious, apparently. So we're going to have any submission to the Reddit. We're going to have a moderator, mod mail subject of suspicious post, a mod mail of this is a suspicious post. You should check it out. And let's go and test that. All right, we are on the NHL 24 page. I'm logged into my own account and we are going to test. We're just going to post something. And immediately when we post something, this lights up our moderation. We've got a mod mail. So when we open up the mod mail, we get suspicious post. It's titled suspicious post. You see my other one here to make sure it was working. And then we've got the link to our page. And this post is suspicious. You should check it out. If you click the link to it, it'll bring you right to the suspicious post. So that way you can check it out. But yes, you can configure this to whatever you want. You can be like, if somebody has a certain keyword in here, you can be like, okay, send a mod mail. For this example, I just did every single post so that way it was easier. But for all of these things that I showed you guys, all five of these different things, plus any of the things you found in my other videos, you can all just configure them together however you want. Just add another thing onto each one of your rules so that way you can do multiple things with one different rule. However, if you do something like, I'm going to remove this and then I'm going to remove that in the same rule, you probably need two rules to be able to do that. Otherwise, you won't really be able to, it wouldn't make sense in the rule and it wouldn't do it in your auto moderator. But anyway, I hope all of these helped you guys and you were able to learn a bunch more about auto moderator. As always, if you guys have any questions about auto moderator, feel free to comment down below. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next video.